Assalamu alaikum friends, how are you? Hope you will be fine and you are watching If the Heart Academy. So friends, our topic is today source of international law under Article 38 of International Court of Justice. We will discuss introduction, meaning, definition, classification of sources of law and sources, main sources of law, and in last we will also discuss conclusion. So let's start with introduction. International law is a body of rules which regulates relations among states. It is also known public international law and law of nations. It is necessary for maintaining peace in the world. The origin international law can be back to the 15th century. International law provides some rules and regulations to regulate a state, and also provides some rights and duties of the state. Meaning, international laws are those laws which governs legal relation among states. According to Oppenheim, law of nations or international law is named for the body of customary and conventional rules which are considered binding on civilized states in which their relations with each others. Classifications of sources of law: there are two sources of material sources and formal sources. Let's start with formal sources. Formal sources are those sources from which the law derives its force and validity, are called formal sources. Material sources are those sources from which the law derives its material and substance, are called material sources. The next one is discuss main sources of international law. Let's start with the treaties. Treaties are the first and foremost source of international law. A treaty is an agreement between two states, two or more states, which whereby they undertake to carry out obligations imposed on them. International treaties occupy same significant position in international law as legislation has importance in municipal law. Most of the ICJ cases are decided on the basis of treaties between the states. The next one is sources is international customs. International customs are one of the most important source of international law. The Article 38 of the Statute of International Court of Justice recognizes that international customs are important source of law. Essentials of international customs: it must be reasonable and immemorial. Number two is it must be universal. Number three point is not opposed to the public policy, and number four, not opposed to the public laws. General principles of law recognized by the civilized states and also an important source of international law. General principles rules are which have been recognized by almost all the states. The next one is judicial decisions. Under Article 39 of International Court of Justice, judicial decisions are also an important source of law, because such kinds of judicial decisions of the court are binding, considered by the International Court of Justice during the enactment of law. The next one is international conventions. Under the Article 38 of International Court of Justice, international conventions are also an important source of law, because such kinds of international conventions of the country are being considered by International Court of Justice during the enactment of international law. In last conclusion, to conclude, I can say that International Court of Justice has multiple sources of international laws, such as treaties, international customs, general principles of law, judicial decisions, and the last one is international conventions. Therefore, sources played a great role in the development of international law and creation of international law. So it was a topic of sources of international law under Article 38 of International Court of Justice. Thanks for watching If the Heart Academy. Allah Hafiz.